Universal logo before. Every time I'm in a theater and I'm waiting for the movie to start and I see those big giant metal letters appearing over the earth, I can't help but feel that there's a disaster movie happening as I'm waiting to watch another movie. What if the Universal logo is real? I don't know, and I want to figure out the answer with you. That's right, I'm bringing you along for the journey to answer the question of what does it look like? What would happen? Is this even possible? Are you hungry? I'm hungry. Did you want to eat lunch? No, I already ate lunch. Never mind, I'm good. That was my dessert. Here is the logo we're dealing with. In science, normally when you try to answer a question like this, you come up with a hypothesis first. What do you think is gonna happen? And in this situation, it's not that I think anything is gonna happen, it's that I want something to happen. What I want is for all of these characters to have so much mass that it just rips up the ground on Earth and stuff goes flying up into the air. That looks tasty. What if the Universal logo was real? I'm a little nervous because there's already a little bit of information about this. Oh, whoa, dude, look at this. They've already got it up in the sky.
Whoa.
Okay, we're onto something here right off the bat.
So they already did it then?
They didn't do
it. Cancel the video.
Don't cancel. Wait.
Should I turn it off?
No, don't cancel the video. Oh, we just started. Okay. You see this right here? I don't even know if this is right. I mean, that's why we're doing this video. Oh, hey, look, Metaball Studio. Well, he's made a bunch of stuff showing context of scale. Wow. Okay, now that's some context of scale right there. Okay. That's just the U. That's just the U.
Is that the United States?
Oh, wow.
That's cool.
That really kind of puts it into perspective how big this is.
Do you think these letters are big enough to have their own influence on gravity?
Dude, I hope so. I don't know yet, but that's what I'm gonna try to figure out.
What are they gonna be made out of?
Another good question. Haven't gotten to that one yet.
It looks like they're made out of metal.
I assume they're made out of metal. This is a great starting point, but I wanna figure out what would happen. And since Universal won't email me their project file, I have to recreate the logo from scratch so that I can get an accurately scaled 3D model of each of these letters, so I can figure out the volume of each of them, so then I can figure out how much each of those letters weigh, so then I can actually figure out what the gravity of them would be and if that would actually affect the Earth. Basically, I know the exact size of the Earth. It's 12,742 kilometers wide. By scaling up this sphere to the exact size of Earth, I can then determine how big the actual characters are in relation to that by simply measuring its size. Also, haircut transition. Okay, so I built out the Universal logo to scale. I got it as close as I could. I even got the bevels as close as I could. This was the key ingredient I'd been missing up until this point. Now we can proceed. So before we even start talking about gravity, mass, volume, and all that stuff, we can actually straight up just put a camera on the surface of Earth here. We live here in LA, so I'm just gonna put the camera roughly here in LA. I think that's about right here, so. Okay, since the Universal logo is basically going around the equator, that's due south from here right now, so I'm gonna point the camera south. This is what it would look like. Okay, so if that's what it, I mean, obviously the ground is all like kind of wonky looking, but roughly that should be what it looks like here. You know what? Why are we looking at this janky render? Let's go up to the roof and actually take a look. I swear, every time I come into this room, something goofy is happening. Oh man, it's so bright. There it is. Look at that. This is crazy. It stretches across the entire horizon here. Just a big arc, like the world's biggest double rainbow all the way. So most people think that the Universal logo would be like directly above their heads. And if you live in Brazil, that might be the case. But we are pretty far north here in Los Angeles, so we're looking down on the top of the letters there. The further north you go, the more that this is going to disappear behind the horizon. In fact, if you live in Alaska, you wouldn't be able to see the Universal logo at all. Sorry, Alaska, you don't get no movies. All right, so now that we know what it looks like, we can actually use all this to figure out the physics of all of this. It's time to do some math and actually figure out if this really would be a disaster movie. Oh God! Physics. To figure out how this will affect the Earth, I first need to figure out how much each of these letters weigh. how much mass they have. But to figure that out, I first need to figure out how much volume they have, how much space they take up. Fortunately, I have a plugin in C4D called Vonk Suite. I can just press a button and it tells me the volume, which is great. I have the volume now, but that's only half the battle to figuring out their mass. We need to know what they're made out of. What materials are these? I mean,
it looks like they're made out of metal.
I think it's safe to assume that they're metal, but there's lots of different kinds of metals. What kind of metal would the Universal logo be?
Also, are they hollow?
Hollow?
Or solid?
Solid. I was assuming they're solid. They could be just like freaking blankets. Seth, is the Universal logo hollow or solid?
I think it's hollow.
Griffin, hollow or solid?
Oh, dude, that thing's totally solid.
Hollow or solid?
I'd go with solid, probably.
Hollow or solid?
Sollow.
Definitely solid.
Solid.
Is this a real microphone?
Yes.
Hollow.
Hollow.
Solid.
Oh my gosh. Freaking solid AF, son.
I think it's safe to say that we can assume that these are just solid metal. Thank God, because that makes my job easier. What are they made out of? Oh my God, do we have to do another poll? The whole thing could be platinum with a little bit of gold lining, or it could all be silver, which is a lot lighter. Actually, okay, I just realized, the density of platinum and gold are almost the same.
Platinum.
Platinum, yeah. I now have the density of platinum, and I have all of the volumes. I can multiply those two numbers together to get the mass. That will allow me to figure out how much gravity these letters have. The universal letters, if you were to melt them all down into one like platinum moon, it would weigh 1 trillion trillion kilograms. That's insane. This is shaping up. It's this. Earth is like 5.97 trillion trillion kilograms. This is 1.2 trillion trillion kilograms. Earth weighs 5 times more than the universal logo. So the next step is to figure out its gravitational forces. The equation is actually fairly simple, acceleration due to gravity. Ever heard of g-forces? You basically just take your mass and you divide it by the radius of it squared. So the giant platinum moon above me, if I was to stand on its surface, I would actually feel heavier. I would weigh 50% more on the platinum moon than I do here. That is insane because this moon is a lot smaller in size than the Earth. But because it's so much more dense, we're talking like 5-6 times more dense, and the radius is so much smaller that I feel that gravitational pull so much more greatly. More greatly. So surely, with it above my head, it would lift me up off the ground, right? That's what I want. I want to be lifted up off the ground. I want this to be a disaster movie. But it's not all in one big frickin' sphere above my head. It's distributed across the sky, which means I'm gonna have, like, gravity affect me from that way, gravity affect me that way, upwards here. And I don't exactly know how to calculate the gravity for a big distributed area. And I don't know how to figure it out. I feel like I need to talk to an expert about this. So I have a friend. I think he can help me with this.
What are you doing?
What are you doing for
you
the
video
question?
We're doing hands-on science.
I actually have a phone call with the real scientist right now, so I gotta go.
Gatekeeping science.
What up?
Hey, what's up?
If you haven't heard of Scott Manley, then you probably don't like rockets. If you do like rockets, then you like Scott Manley. That's all that needs to be said. Dude, first off, thank you so much for chatting with me. So I'm trying to figure out what would happen once it has arrived. Now that it's here, like, will it lift people up off the ground?
You know, the Earth, you gotta imagine, it's like a big drop of liquid magma, and it takes time to sort of relax. So if they just fly by and go off into space, stuff will be bad, but maybe not terminal.
Let's say we're assuming that they're just stopped and they're not in orbit, they're just hovering there through whatever force. If the letter E is directly above my head, would the other characters, which are like slightly to the side of it and like past the horizon, would they also be affecting the gravitation?
They all affect you and they're pulling you in different directions, so yeah.
How would I calculate that?
You just assume they're a point mass, one for each letter at the correct position.
Okay.
And then you've got one big point mass at the center of the Earth, and you can just add these up as force vectors. And it's super easy to do.
Sure.
Yeah, just add them all up.
Okay.
It's just a vector sum.
So like, there's a lot of upwards totaled vectors going up.
Yeah.
But then you also have vectors to the left and the right pulling, which would cancel out, presumably.
Which would tend to cancel out, but if you're, say, on the side of the Earth here, you will have more in one direction than the other, right? So it's gonna be like, if you're on the sides of the Earth, you know, 90 degrees away from the center, you're going to feel like it's going downhill, right? You're going to, everything will be flowing downhill. Water is all going to rush to the equator because that's going to move faster than the rock a little.
Okay, fair.
You're not going to have any ocean at the North Pole anymore because all the water's run south. So the further north you are, the less air you have to breathe because it gets sucked towards the equator. So people that are like up in London or whatever, their air is rushing down towards the equator.
So it'd be very windy and then they'd suffocate.
Yeah, pretty much. Totally. And even if these are massless, even if they're just like projections, they're casting shadows that are going to be messing with the ecosystem, yeah. Right? You know, are there curved areas that would make like a parabola and focus the light into like a beam?
Yeah, in theory, like the S, the inside of the S could probably like focus it at the right spot,
right?
On Earth.
You heard about the tail in Vegas that was curved and it was like melting.
Yeah.
Stuff is, yeah.
That's like a freaking death ray from space. Oh, yeah. Hey, look, a movie's starting. And then you just fried.
Boy.
The Earth is toast.
Yeah, the Earth is toast. Yep. The Earth is not going to be left.
Scott blew my mind. Turns out I do know how to figure this out. I just didn't realize it. It sounded complicated, vectorizing the gravitational forces, but once you actually break them out into the X and Y coordinates, they just add up, and so everything from the left and right should mostly cancel out, and everything going up will add up. I'm just adding ups. This is the moment of truth. Add up all of these gravitational forces from the Universal logo to figure out if it really can just lift me up. If you are right underneath the E, you would feel 14% lighter.
That's it?
Wow. This is science. It doesn't matter what I want. Like 14%, like sure, I might be able to jump an extra inch or two higher. Not quite the disaster film I was anticipating, but Scott and I have been talking, and turns out I have yet to account for probably the most important ingredient of all, and that is time. So I think it is time to tell you what time will do. Let's hit play on the sim. Let's see what happens. If the Universal logo suddenly appeared one day in orbit, you wouldn't initially notice much, unless you live near the ocean, because you would be one of the first people to perish from this cataclysm. Instead of tides, there would be giant tsunamis wrecking every coastline in the world, multiple times per day. Over 3 billion people live near the coast, and all of them would be underwater as the waves reach hundreds of miles inland. If you were lucky enough to find the high ground, well, now you have to contend with out-of-control tornadoes and hurricanes as the air rushes towards the equator, and the world's oceans would also migrate towards the equator, forming a new oceanic belt around the entire planet, leaving the rest of the world dry. Because the tidal forces from the Universal logo are a million times greater than from the moon, the Earth itself begins to deform. The equator bulges outwards hundreds of miles, causing near constant earthquakes. Volcanoes erupt as the magma is squeezed out of the mantle. The Universal logo is already devastating everything you love, but it is just getting started. Up in space, chaos is beginning to unfold. The letters are so dense that instead of breaking up into a beautiful ring, each letter would collapse under its own gravity. They would begin crashing into each other as their collective gravity brings them together into a single new moon. You might be safe in a submarine at the equator, but you won't be safe for long. The collisions between the letters in space literally splash molten platinum out into space, which then falls down to Earth as the hard rain. Each platinum raindrop could have ended the dinosaurs on their own, but the rainfall of so many all at once truly redefines what hell is. The atmosphere heats up thousands of degrees and the oceans boil. Eventually, the entire surface of the Earth melts as well, and nothing could possibly survive that. It is over for us. But you might be surprised at what eventually happens. Millions of years later, our once beautiful planet has finally cooled off and solidified. The oceans have even reformed after centuries of constant rain. But in place of a shiny metal moon, there would appear to be another Earth. Ejecta from the initial bombardment sent out enough debris into space that much of it ends up landing on this metal moon, forming a rocky crust and even tiny little oceans. Both worlds resemble what the Earth looked like billions of years ago. And who knows, maybe life could one day evolve again, but on both worlds this time. Imagine looking up into space at the other world with those living there looking back at us, wondering what life must be like here. I feel like there's a movie idea here, and I think Universal Pictures should make it. Hooray! Thank you so much for watching this video. I tried really hard to make this as accurate as I could, but I am definitely no orbital mechanical scientist at all. But someone else is. Scott Manley is making a video going into much greater detail about all the math and the equations involved. I recommend checking it out. The video is linked in the description, or just, you know, click whatever's over here. You know, click it. You still haven't clicked it yet. You got 5 more seconds. I said click!